brought to you by Geritol, the high-potency vitamin iron-rich tonic in liquid or tablets to help you feel stronger. And now, let's all play What's My Line? Live from New York, let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, the talented lady who is delighting audiences in the current Broadway play Chin Chin, Miss Arlene Francis.
And now a comedian who opens May 13th at Scioli's in Philadelphia, the wildly funny Buddy Hackett.
I'm so now the nationally syndicated columnist of the Joey Bishop Show of the New York Journal American, Mr. Arthur Kilgallen.
And now our publisher panelist, our own wonderful Bennett Cerf.
I must tell you what our panel moderator just said. He said he thought he might have a little trouble understanding Buddy Hackett tonight because he doesn't always hear people who speak above a whisker.
Never said that.
So I think he deserves everything he gets. Here he is, our panel moderator, John Charles Daly.
I want it clearly understood that on this program, the chair is not necessarily responsible for any remarks made by a member of the panel. Buddy, it's fine to see you here.
Thank you, sir.
Nice of you to bring Joey, or rather, for Joey to come with you to the theater tonight. I saw you two characters last night, as I guess most of us in the theater did.
Well, a friend of ours is opening at the Latin Quarter tonight. Corbett Monica, who plays Larry on Joey's show, and we're going to go over to see him. So we took our wives out for a change.
Well, it promises to be quite an evening. We've had a good beginning, and we have some very interesting occupations. We'll also have a famous mystery guest before my friends on the panel a little bit later in the program, and we'll meet our first challenger after this.
Social anxiety disorder is an intense, persistent fear and avoidance of social situations. Over 10 million suffer. Do you? Does an unreasonable fear of embarrassment cause you to avoid most social interaction? Is your anxiety around people so intense it can feel like a panic attack? Has this overwhelming anxiety significantly impaired your work or social life? Now Paxil, the only medication proven effective for social anxiety disorder, offers new hope. Paxil can help you overcome your anxiety so that in time, with your doctor's help, you may move toward recovery. Paxil is not for everyone. Tell your doctor what medicines you're taking. People taking MAO inhibitors shouldn't take Paxil. Side effects may include decreased appetite, dry mouth, sweating, nausea, constipation, sexual side effects in men and women, yawn, tremor, or sleepiness. Will you ask your doctor for more information about Paxil? Do it today. Your life is waiting.
What's it take to be a Hollywood player?
Number one box office movie, Titanic. Ouch! Ricky's contract is so hot it burns, baby! Gotta run. Something important just came up.
What's it take to be a Hollywood player? Simple. Just play the game. Hollywood Showdown, weeknights 8 Eastern on Game Show Network.
Oh, watch the hands, pal.
And now to meet our first contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please? Sonia Tyler, is that right? Is it Miss or Mrs. Tyler?
Mrs.
Mrs. Tyler, where are you from?
Forestville, Maryland.
Fordsville?
Forestville.
Forestville, Maryland. Is that, where is that, in close to the Washington area or up the other?
About 10 miles outside of Washington.
10 miles outside of Washington. Nice to have you with us. May I present our panel?
Now, would you join me over here?
You know how we keep score on What's My Line?
Yes.
All right, then we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. All right. Panel, we'll tell you that Mrs. Tyler is salaried and deals in a service. And we'll begin the general questioning with Bennett, sir.
Mrs. Tyler, is your service in any way connected with some sporting activity?
No.
Nope. One down and nine to go, Miss Francis.
Did the audience enjoy your whatever it is that you do because it is an unusual thing for a girl like you to be doing?
Yes.
Do you work for a non-profit making organization?
Yes.
Do you wear any sort of garment other than a dress in your job?
Yes.
Would it be considered in any way a uniform or cover all costume?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Mr. Hackett.
Well, could I avail myself of this service?
Well, buddy, we would have to say only in a very general way. We would have to assume that you as a member of a community would in some degree avail yourself of the service because it's a service for a non-profit organization.
I was in good shape before you started to explain to me. do you have anything to do with some kind of machinery?
You mean above the usual relationship of any person to machinery?
Like if she ran a car wash.
Oh, that's fine. That's three down and seven to go. Miss Kilgallen.
Mrs. Tyler, do you work indoors?
No.
Four down and six to go, Mr. Sir.
Mrs. Tyler, we've established that you work for a non-profit making organization. Is it a government of some kind?
Yes.
Is it the federal government?
No.
Five down and five to go, Miss Francis.
Now, to get back to your job, are you ever off the ground in your work?
But now you're speaking here of not, when you say off the ground, you're not talking about walking up steps or something like that.
No, I'm not, John. If you want to give me a no, go ahead.
That's fine. Six down and four to go, Mr. Hackett.
You work for city government?
No.
Seven down and three to go, Miss Kilgallen.
State government?
No.
Eight down and two to go, Mr. Sir.
Not state, not city, not national. It must be then. County government.
Yeah.
Right.
County government. Is this, can we rule out anything to do with the law and penal institutions?
Yeah.
Would this then be some kind of a job that might improve or protect the health or well-being of citizens?
It could have the application, in certain instances, certainly of protecting the health and well-being of the citizenry.
Mrs. Tyler, are there any animals connected with the work that you do?
Yes.
Are they four-legged animals?
Yes.
Dogs?
Yes.
Don't tell me you're a dog catcher.
Yes. Yes, Dorothy.
Arlene asked about uniforms or coveralls. What is the uniform or coveralls?
Mrs. Tyler wears slacks and a blouse. There's no formal uniform or coverall. No, actually, Mrs. Tyler is dog catcher in Prince George's County in Maryland.
Mrs. Tyler, I bet you're the prettiest dog catcher in the United States of America.
Well, thank you.
I'd just like to say one thing, though. Thank you, Mrs. Tyler.
To meet our second contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please? Eleanor. Hansberry, is that right?
Is it
Miss or Mrs. Hensby?
Mrs.
Mrs. Hensby, and where are you from, ma'am?
Hollywood, Florida.
Hollywood, Florida. Nice to have you with us. Mrs. Hensby, may I present the panel? Now, would you join me over here, please? You know how we keep score.
Yes, I do.
All right, then we'll let the audience here and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. All right. Panel, Mrs. Hensby is self-employed, deals in a product. And we'll begin the general questioning with Buddy Hackett.
This product you're dealing, is it edible?
Yes.
Is it of a citrus variety?
Pardon?
Is it a citrus fruit?
No.
No. One down and nine to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Is it something that would be stocked by the ordinary grocery store or supermarket?
Yes.
Could I hold it in my hand?
Yes.
Would it be served at dinner, normally?
Yes.
Would it be served as something other than the main course?
Yes.
Would it be a side dish, rather than a first course or dessert?
I would say it would come in the general category of side dishes if your differentiation is that is it first course or dessert is against main course.
Uh-huh. Is it anything in the accessory to a meal? Would you put it on anything or eat it with something rather than just by itself?
Yes.
Well, I think the answer would be yes and no to that.
Has it ever been in any other form before it's in the form in which you deal with it?
Yes.
Was it larger when it was in the other form?
No.
No. That's two down and eight to go, Mr. Sir.
Mrs. Hensby, was this product ever alive before you started kidding around with it?
No.
Never.
3 down and 7 to go, Miss Francis.
Does it have the quality of a condiment in any way? Is it a spicy thing or a very tasty accessory?
But in the sense of a condiment, tasty in the sense of a condiment or a spice.
You're trying to get me to say she got off the ground again?
4 down and 6 to go. Mr. Hackett?
Is this a pickled sort of thing?
A pickled sort of thing? 5 to go.
Is this packaged in glass, usually?
No.
6 down and 4 to go, Mr. Sir.
Can this product be eaten without being cooked?
Yes.
Is it very often eaten without being cooked?
Yes, I would say here, Bennett, again, we have to go back to the basic product as Mrs. Hensby knows it. When Mrs. Hensby is concerned with the product, it does not need to be cooked to be eaten.
Might this product be raised in or near Hollywood, Dade County in Florida?
No.
It is not.
7 down and 3 to go, Miss Francis.
Is there any flour in this product? Yes. Is it any member at all of the bread family? Yes. Is it more unusual than just a loaf of bread? Don't turn the card. It makes me so nervous. I mean, is it something like a bagel or a pretzel?
You see, you should have let me turn the cards. I'm going to turn all the cards over because really you did get it, Arlene. It is a loaf of bread. It's diet bread. It's of a special character.
Oh.
But I think you clearly got it. Actually, Mrs. Hensby is the president of the Hollywood Diet Bread Company. Now, I find this bread fascinating. I'm going to ask Mrs. Hensby to tell you all what is in it, what it's made out of. Would you tell us?
Well, it has 8 vegetables in it, and it has 49 calories, and anybody that's on a diet naturally are watching their calories, so it is low in calories.
Is it 49 calories to a bread or to a
46
slice?
46 calories to a whole bread? No, to the slice.
But it's got carrots and cauliflower and cabbage.
I hope it tastes better than it sounds.
It's delicious.
It's delicious. Carrots in it?
Oh, yeah. Well, it's all made into the flour, though.
You just put some salad dressing on it.
I knew that Buddy would have something to stop us with. Thank you very much, Mr.
And
Hanks.
Thank
it's been
you,
nice
Mr.
to
Daly.
Have you with us and watch my life. We'll meet tonight's mystery guest in just a moment, but first, here is a word from our sponsor.
Please be home.
Witness the power of the tarot.
Well, he's older. Old enough to be your father?
He's 48, and I'm 25.
Is he your teacher?
You're incredible. My husband is driving me crazy.
I see the devil card. He wants to dominate you like he's your king.
Exactly.
He tells you how to dress, how to talk, where you can go.
Yes. Wow. You're describing the situation perfectly.
I see the Empress. Is someone pregnant?
Wow. I wasn't going to tell you that, but...
But it's not your current girlfriend, is it?
No, it's not. It's my ex-girlfriend. This is amazing.
The King of Cups card shows a very faithful man. One who loves you deeply, by the way.
Well, I found out he's had about 10 times the number of past lovers that I've had.
Look, his past history is just that. History. Now all he wants is you.
Caution. A tarot card reading may be very personal and intense. Be prepared for amazing revelations. Call for your free tarot reading now.
1-800-799-7244.
I took the risks and started my own business. Taking risks, that's what you have to do. But here's a way to help your business with no risk at all. Just call for your free trial version of QuickBooks Pro, America's number one best-selling small business accounting software. That's right, I said free. For no money, not even a shipping charge, you'll get this free trial version of QuickBooks Pro from the makers of Quicken, so you know it's easy to use.
Want to write a check? You just start typing, and QuickBooks Pro fills in the rest. It shows you how much money you're owed and who owes it.
It even prints invoices with your company logo. And QuickBooks Pro can save you even more time with features like estimating and job costing. And it integrates with Microsoft Word and Excel. Look, we all take risks in business. Now take advantage of an honest, no-risk opportunity. Call for your free QuickBooks Pro trial version now. There's no bill, no hassle. There's no risk. You can't do better than that.
Call 1-800-668-2170.
All new, three's a crowd. Find out who knows you best weeknights at 9:30 Eastern, 6:30 Pacific.
And now the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery challenger, for which the panel is blindfolded. Blindfolds in place, panel?
Yes, sir. Uh-huh.
Good. Will you enter mystery challenger and sign in, please? As you know, panel, different form of questioning now. One question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise. And we'll begin with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Well, I know Mrs. Kennedy isn't making personal appearances. But that applause, are you in show business?
Yeah.
Mr. Sir?
Would you be in the metropolitan area by any chance to help exploit a new motion picture in which you are a star?
Yeah.
Miss Francis?
Is there possibly more than one person there?
Yeah.
Mr. Hackett?
Did you become famous in television? Yeah.
Miss Kilgallen?
Is one of you red-haired and the other ski-nosed?
Oh.
It is Bob Hope and
Jim. Yeah,
that is. I think you carry it. I think you've carried us a couple.
You carried us about twice,
didn't you?
A little bit. Bob came in and signed Bob Ball. Lucy came in and signed Lucy Hope. And the first time Bob tried to make an answer, Lucy nearly lost her left hand.
What about my caps?
Bob almost lost his cat.
I don't think anybody mentioned the picture, which is Critics' Choice that you're...
Thank you. There she goes.
Critics' Choice.
Thank you, Arlene.
She knows.
And as a publisher, Bob, I think you should say something about your new book, even though I didn't publish it.
That's pretty sweet for a competitor.
I think so.
Well, the name, I will say that the name of the book is I Owe Russia $1,200, and it's a great deal of fun, and I've read it, and only Bob Hope could do that and get away with it.
I don't want Bennett to know this, but I'll be in Doubleday's window tomorrow at 1 o'clock.
When you finish washing the windows, I'd like
show.
You to come over to our house.
I think I'm going on your show tomorrow. Are you at Sardi's? Are you at Sardi's, Arlene?
Yes,
I may be. I may have you in a sandwich tomorrow.
Oh, I hope so. I'd like that.
What'd you say, buddy?
It's dead now.
I thought... you know, I thought that was Orson Welles. So
is that Buddy Hackett?
That's Buddy Hackett.
How are you, Buddy?
No, it's Gene Kelly. I always come here to dance like this.
I must say, one thing that has always astonished me about both these good people...
You're in the rough, huh?
No, is the energy that you both have. Bob, you're going to be in the University of Cincinnati in midweek, aren't you?
Thank you very much,
and
John.
Now, where
that's
are you
on
going?
Wednesday we're going to
yeah,
do
but then
that.
Where are you going?
And I'm going to Ohio University.
Ohio University. I knew you were going to be at two universities.
Thank you very much.
What are you going to do?
You think you'll ever graduate?
I'm stealing Bennett's racket. I'm doing a show there for Halfway House, a house for kids.
Wonderful.
You're making it pretty tough for me.
We played 11 theaters yesterday, Lucy and myself, opening Critics' Choice.
19 altogether.
If you think we're not in shape, I'm going right to the Mayo Clinic right after.
Well, you
we actually did. We
you couldn't go. You go up and see Don Soans and tell him I sent you.
All
you
right.
know Dr. Soans up there?
No. Where's that? Right. Mayo Clinic?
At Mayo's, yeah. He's Charlie Mayo's.
He's son not really son. Going to Mayo
they've
Clinic,
asked,
John.
They won't let him in.
They've asked me to use the servant's entrance.
That may be serious for a moment, but, oh, I guess it was 3 weeks ago. I presided at a dinner here in New York given by the USO. And good Lord knows that it
he
serves...
He was a master of ceremonies, and I never knew he could work standing up.
But you all know what the USO does. I think probably it does the greatest service for our youngsters, all of whom have to see military service. But the point I was trying to make is Robert got the gold medal. He's the second to get the USO gold medal. Cardinal Francis Cardinal Spellman gets the first one. And it was a great night for all of us. It was a great dinner, but he made it even greater than it might ordinarily have been. And nobody deserved that gold medal more than you did.
Thank you, John. I appreciate... Thank you, John. I appreciate you showing up. You were real fine that night. A little too funny, in fact.
Now, what actually happened was I stood up and said, with Robert there, I wasn't going to dare to tell a joke, and I didn't even try.
Is that the truth? You were pretty good.
I read the stock market report.
You were pretty good.
Is Lucy going to school with you?
No, I'm going back and do my show with Vivian.
Oh, yeah, that's good.
Well, I have one final word to two people who have been to 19 theaters in the last 2 days.
That's
with
right.
their Picture Critics' Choice. Thank you for giving us the
You know the way we
Sunday
feel?
Night.
The Thank way you. I feel about it, John, I helped kill vaudeville and I'd like to restore it, and we try.
Good to see you both. Panel, you've done remarkably well so far tonight, and we'll have another contestant after this word from our alternate sponsor.
In families, it's like what's mine is yours. Everyone shares everything, right down to the cold germs. With Kleenex Cold Care, you get 3 germ-blocking layers to help catch cold germs and keep them there. Hey, if there's one thing we can all be a little selfish about, it's our cold germs. Kleenex Cold Care, with or without lotion. Share the love, not the germs.
Fresh as mountain falls, clear, crisp, pure, and true. Mr. Clean brings the refreshing scent of all outdoors to you.
The refreshing clean of mountain air, captured in Mr. Clean's mountain fall scent.
Mr. Clean.
Check it out. All dressed up and nowhere to go, you're invited to our black and white ball. I've Got a Secret to Tell the Truth and Classic Password are up next.
And now to meet a final contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please? Wim Olson. William Olson, right there. Where are you from, Mr. Olson?
Brooklyn.
From Brooklyn, New York? Fine. Good. You're sure to have a lot of fun. Mr. Olson, may I present our panel? Now, will you join me over here, please, sir? Do you know how we keep score, Mr. Olson?
Yes, I do.
Fine, then we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is.
I think he arrested me once.
All right. Panel, we can tell you that Mr. Olson is salaried and deals in a service. And let's begin the general questioning with Arlene Francis.
Mr. Olson, is your work very difficult? Is it a hard job?
At times.
Do you go to people rather than people coming to you?
Yes.
Do you find that the people that you go to are sometimes unhappy as a result of your visit, as nice as you are?
No.
Well, I must say this. I doubt very much that Mr. Olson ever made anybody unhappy wittingly, but there are circumstances under which a visit by Mr. Olson might not result in all of the happy conclusions that...
Does Mr. Olson have anything whatsoever to do with law and order?
No.
That's one down and nine to go, Mr. Hackett.
I guess he didn't arrest me then. When you go to people, do you carry something with you?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Ms. Kilgallen.
I said yes.
Mr. Olson, may I assume that by law and order you also exclude private detectives or process servers?
Yes.
Good. Do you work for a profit-making organization?
No.
Three down and seven to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Olson, has your work got anything to do with education?
No.
Four down and six to go, Miss Francis.
Does it have anything to do with social work or welfare work?
No.
Five down and five to go, Mr. Hackett.
Is this a personal service that you do when you go to someone's house?
I beg your pardon?
Is this a personal service that you render?
You mean delivered specifically to one person rather than to a group of people?
No, something to one person in a personal way that would just this person would accept at that time without another person watching.
Well, now that I understand your question, buddy, that's no. Six down and four to go, Miss Kilgall.
Mr. Olson, could I avail myself of your services?
Yes.
Yeah, I'm going to have to put all the cards over because, unhappily, we're running out of time. This was a very tough one. You were beginning to get close to it. Actually, Mr. Olson inspects and tests rides out at the Coney Island Amusement Park. He works for the Buildings Department of the City of New York.
Thank you very much, Mr. Olson. Nice to have you here.
Nice to have you with us tonight, Buddy Hackett, and good night, Miss Arlene Francis.
Thank you, John, and good night, dear Buddy. Have a very successful engagement in Philadelphia.
Thank you very much. Good night, Dottie.
Good night, Buddy. Don't forget to come back next week when Joey is here.
Yeah, I'll be the mystery guest.
Good night, Bennett.
John, what do you think of our Mets?
Oh, listen, I think the fever that has caught the city for the Mets is wonderful. I guess that's in our nature. And if wishing alone will make them a great ball team, they're going to be a great ball team.
They'll need more than wishing.
And thanks to you, ladies and gentlemen, for being with us on What's My Line.
Private Parts is a book by A. Pee Wee Herman, B. Pamela Lee, C. None of the Above.
Inquisition, weeknights at 7 and 11 Eastern.